what brought him to Vallejo? What brought him to the Lord, really? That question I can't answer. But Steve was, I've known him since he was a teenager. When he tells you he was a rebel, believe him, because he was. The raw material that God took in this young man and then just sort of molded him into the man that he's become. He had a lot of rough edges, and I've watched those rough edges be chipped off and polished. Amy and my granddaughter Jennifer were going to the same school, and somebody told me Steve had started a new church. So I saw Steve and Karen, and I asked them about it, and I said, okay, tell me where you are, because that's where I'm going to go. And the next Sunday I was there, and I have been there ever since, so that's pushing 25 years now.
The significance of Bible study fellowship groups at CBC is seeing God's Word be the difference in people's lives. We have seen the group grow in many ways, and now most of them faithfully serve the church. Many have left the group to serve the children on Wednesday nights. Many have experienced the truth of God's Word in their lives. People come for what they can give and how they can serve the others. We see this in their hospitality, their giving to each other, and their caring for one another. Some go out of their way, make time, and provide a space to serve the others. We experience fellowship and hospitality and love in the Spirit, and we give all the thanks and glory to God.
Back in the early 80s, I started a Bible study in my house, and it really started to grow a lot. And we needed a church because in addition to the Bible study, we did a local outreach to the community and it started to grow. So we definitely needed a church to grow into. And so through a friend, he invited us to Community Bible Church, and a bunch of us back in July 18th of 1984 came and sat in the front row. That's about, I don't know, 15, 20 of us came and sat in the front row and heard the word preached. And afterwards, Steve came down and we came and surrounded him and asked him questions about the church. And one of the things that really grabbed us was his principles for discipleship and small groups. And from that point on, we knew we found a home in Community Bible Church. And so since then, we've really grown. The principles have continued, the principles for discipleship of people reaching faithful people, teaching faithful people. And that has grown and excelled into what we have going on today.
Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. Love your neighbor as yourself. God's your love.
It really has been a joy to watch the kids and to work with them. You know, to be part of the team that has the opportunity to plant the seed and share the Word of God with the children, and then for that to come back and for us to see the fruits of our labor as we watch these kids go on to TFC and then into the high school ministry and, you know, get saved and come back and then serve with us as leaders. And that's really the reward, is to watch those return and come back, because they have the same heart now for the kids, because that's where they began, and knowing that, you know, Christ has changed their life and that it starts at a young age. And so we just rejoice for all of those leaders that have returned, the young people as well as all of our regulars, and we're just grateful to God for what He's doing, and just to see Him work, and really to understand that this really is the generation to come.
The summer ministry is the volleyball outreach, and it really is an outreach because every practice and every game day there's a message taught, and during the practices there's testimonies given by the coaches mixed in with a whole series that lasts all summer long, and it's like you learn a lot through that. And during the messages on Friday in between the first game and the second game, the different preachers give evangelistic messages which pierce hearts, they tend to pierce hearts, and is good. And toward the end of the summer, we have the summer camp, and I've gone to every single one. It's great, and I love it. And it's just great because they teach Bible all week long, like two messages a day for 7 days straight, and then there's discussion groups. So kids learn a lot. These kids and teenagers learn a lot about Jesus, and it's just great. Yeah.
For the past 2 years, I've been attending the Cove Ministry, CBC, meaning Christ Our Vision, and God has actually used this in my life many times for just what's going through my life and what the staff and the leaders of Cove has been showing me and showing me through the Word, and I've just been really encouraged, you know, and learning and growing in the Word and aspects of just learning about Christ and what God's doing. To be able to encourage one another, the body, the brethren, and to bear one another's burdens, and to be able to also go out and share the gospel, the Great Commission, you know, to share with our family, our friends, co-workers, and just, you know, our loved ones, people we have a burden for. So, you know, I thank God for this ministry.
What a privilege to serve the King of Kings. Missions is not about a program. It's about God raising up servants. We've seen over 12 years His faithfulness. He sent over 10 teams to Mexico, 5 to the Philippines. I think we've been to Uganda over 5 times. We've been to South Africa, to India, to Germany, and now Honduras. What a grace that God has given us these opportunities. There's a verse that says, I will dare not speak of any of those things which Christ has not accomplished through me in word and deed. I want to thank God for His faithfulness these last years, and I'm praying that God will continue to use us around the world to advance His kingdom for His glory.
Jesus Christ has commissioned His church to make disciples, to baptize them, but also to teach them to observe all that He had commanded them. And the Apostle Paul told Timothy that he should find faithful men and teach them what he had been taught, but that they would in turn be able to teach others also. Community Bible Church has a long history of discipling, of teaching, with their involvement in discipleship and leadership training development, and also with Grace School of Theology and Ministry. They have a great history of training up leaders. A seminary is the logical extension, the next step of training men that the Holy Spirit would make overseers over His churches. As we have our part in the greater body of Christ, to be able to help people prepare the next generation of expositors and overseers to shepherd the flock of God. The Cornerstone Seminary will be used mightily of God to do that.
On this truth that my life has been formed from the dust.